Hi, my name is David, and this video is an update to a video I did on how to automatically create subtitles and captions for YouTube videos. Now, I'll show you how you can use YouTube to automatically transcribe your videos into closed captions. And basically, what happens is that YouTube uses its automatic speech recognition engine, that is Google's automatic speech recognition engine, to transcribe your video into text. Now, there are a couple of things that you need to know here is that captions are a great way to make your content accessible for viewers. So, for example, people will say I have an accent. That's true. I can speak American or British, but I think my English is fairly good. So, you need to know the languages that are supported for automatic captions on YouTube. And by the time of recording this video, that is May 8th, 2021, automatic captions are available for Dutch, English, French, German, Indonesian, Italian, Japanese, Korean, Portuguese, Russian, Spanish, Turkish, and Vietnamese. So that is out of the way. So if your language is not supported, hopefully YouTube will add it to the list of automatic captions once the automatic speech recognition engines get better. And they are. So the few troubleshooting things that I may mention is that sometimes YouTube doesn't transcribe your video correctly or at all. And these are some of the few things that may result from that. If your video doesn't generate automatic captions, it could be due to one of the following reasons. The captions aren't available yet due to processing complex audio in the video. Number two, automatic captions don't support the language in the video. Number three, the video is too long. Number four, the video has poor sound quality or YouTube doesn't recognize the speech. Number five, there's a long period of silence at the beginning of the video. Finally, there are multiple speakers whose speech overlaps. That is a lot of crosstalk in the particular audio. So let's begin by the process of actually now uploading a video and have YouTube automatically transcribe the video into closed captions. So I'll just create a new video and I'm inside the YouTube studio. Just create, upload a video, and I'll navigate to the folder with the video I want to upload. It's this particular video, how to save Camtasia projects as a standalone project file in Camtasia 2021. So I'll just drag it on the upload videos interface and it's going to start uploading inside YouTube. Now you'll see the upload option here, the various processing levels and the checks that are available for this particular video. You can go ahead and add your description, 2021. Now you can add whatever description that you want. Just add some more meat to the description. You have 5,000 characters to do that, but I'll just scroll down. And since I already have a thumbnail for this particular video, I'll just click on the folder and then let's just drag and drop the particular thumbnail. Here we are. Let's just drag and drop it here. Save Camtasia standalone projects. And it's still processing. And from the playlist section, I'll just click on select and then click on Camtasia tutorials, click on done. And once I click on done, I'll just navigate slightly. Now, under the show more tab, you can guide YouTube to better understand your video. So if I scroll down, you can just say, Camtasia 2021 new features, that is under the tags option, save Camtasia projects as standalone projects, Camtasia 2021 tutorial. And although YouTube has mentioned that the tags are not as useful as they used to be, but help in ensuring that commonly misspelled content can be found by using tags. So I'll also scroll down slightly and go to the language and caption certification. Now, you need to select your video's language and if needed, a caption certification. I will not select the caption certification, but there are a couple that are available here. The content has never aired on, so you can choose whatever you want there if your content is in that particular field. But for the video language, the video is in English, and this helps guide YouTube's automatic speech recognition engine into transcribing your video into English. So you can choose the languages that are supported, as we checked out in this particular link, and I think I can actually maybe have this link available in this particular video, but let's just leave this as English. Now, in the past, this particular section had the option to add a subtitle, or automatic subtitles would be available here once they were ready if you leave your video as a draft. But they have moved, and we'll continue to the next particular next tab. Just click on next. Yes, I want monetization on this video. Click on done. Just scroll down, click on next. And from this particular option, we can now set the ad suitability since we have turned on the monetization. And since I have no any issue with any of these options that have been put out here, then I'll just scroll down, click on none of the above. And once I do that, click on submit rating. And once that is done, we'll get the rating saved and checks complete, no issues found. Click on next. And from this particular section, you'll see the add subtitles, which is a new tab inside the video element section where you can add subtitles if you have a transcript or the subtitles for the file ready. Now, since we don't have a transcript for this video, in quotes, I already have it, I want YouTube to automatically transcribe our video. Now, as we've seen, it may take a long or a short time. So this is the point where you have to wait, either publish your video, leave your video as a draft, and then come back later and see if YouTube automatically transcribed your video into closed captions. So what I can do here, I'll just leave this as it is and then click on add an end screen, and I'll add an end screen, and I'll just scroll down and get this one, one video, one playlist, one subscribe. Click on the playlist section and then set this playlist to be a Camtasia tutorials playlist. And then as for the video up here, I can set it for the best for viewer or choose specific video. I'll just choose a specific video, and let's say I want people to watch more of the Camtasia 2021 tutorials. Let's go for the media mat, since that's a new feature as well in Camtasia 2021. And this helps if people get to the end of your videos, they can keep watching your videos and you keep viewers on YouTube, and YouTube will reward you. Click on save. And then we can click on add a card. And since this is a short video, I'll just add like two cards at around the 19th second. Just click on video. Let's just add the Lottie animation support in Camtasia 2021. And then around this particular section, I can just click on card, video. Let's go for this one, let's go for import captions in Camtasia, and that's it. Now, click on save. Now, once since we're already here, we'll notice that this option or the subtitles have not yet been added. So you'll need to give YouTube some time, because this is a very short video, a minute 40 seconds. I'm sure there's so many people uploading videos on YouTube, so you may need to take a break, go get a coffee or something until YouTube automatically transcribes your video into closed captions. Next, this is the section where you'll see the checks that are available. If you have any copyright checks, you'll see this here. If you have any issues with ad suitability, if you are in the monetization program, then you'll see this here. The next button is for visibility. You can publish your video and the automatic captions will be available later on, but my recommendation is if you're not in a hurry with a particular video, just let that video remain as a draft, and then you'll come back later on and actually now fix the automatic subtitles that will have been created by YouTube. So I'll just close this out and give YouTube some time to process my video into automatic captions. So I'll see you once that is done. Once YouTube is done automatically transcribing our video into automatic captions, then we'll need to go back into the video elements. And this is if you have not yet published your video. If it is still in draft mode, then you can come into the video elements and I'll just click on that. And once I click on the video elements, you'll see that we have English by YouTube into brackets automatic. If you click on the three dots, vertical dots, you can delete a particular automatic subtitle. But if you click on the edit button here, then you have the opportunity to edit the particular timestamps that has been done here. So you can click on edit timings to try and ensure that everything fits what you want. So for example, you can notice that there is no capitalization. Maybe if I just come up to this section, that text might be too much or too little depending on what you're looking at. But for readability, having shorter text would be good for this. But we can just try and listen to the first few lines and get a feel of what the automatic transcription by YouTube feels like. One of the new features in Camtasia 2021 is the ability to save a project as a standalone project. You'll notice that this first part here, one of the new features, I can just start off with a capitalization. Just one of the new features of Camtasia, that's a capital for the C, is the ability to save a project as a standalone project. That's not bad at all, full stop. So we have that one line. One of the new features of the Camtasia 2021 is the ability. We can actually just make this just a single line. And then from this section, let's just come minimize this. We can just pull this back up to there. Then at this section, just click on add and then paste that particular text that we just cut out. And once we do that, we can stretch this to that particular section. So we can just pull this back up slightly, remove the space, Control Z, let that stay there. So we can do a listen again. One of the new features in Camtasia 2021 is the ability to save a project as a standalone project. Now that looks good. It's just a one liner. I wish that it would work the way as I've said it, but I believe if I press on Shift Enter, then it's going to be a two line subtitle like that. This looks good. And you'll keep doing that to make different edits to your subtitle files. For example, this one, if I just click on it, I need to start with a capital A. A standalone project is a project that contains all the files that you've used for your project. That is, the files in the media bin are included in the standalone folder of the project so that you don't end up losing or getting error of file missing, can't locate file, etc. So the one thing that you'll notice with the automatic transcription by YouTube is that the punctuation is not the best. Capitalization of some of the words is not the best. So you'll need to clean up that particular text so that you ensure that your subtitles are up to par. And the reason why you're doing this is because once you do this, your automatic captions will no longer be automatic, but manual captions. Now, manual captions are indexed by YouTube search, and this helps in YouTube SEO. So ensure that whenever you get an automatically transcribed transcript or automatic captions in YouTube, you make edits to that particular text so that YouTube can index the particular captions so that if you have content that should be ranking, it ranks on YouTube. So my assumption is, let's say we are already done. You can click on done, but the three vertical dots next to edit as text help you download the subtitles if you wanted. You can clear the subtitles. You can also upload a file. Now, let's assume I'm done with all the edits that I wanted to make for this particular subtitle. All I need to do is just click on done. And once I click on done, this particular subtitle is going to be saved English by you. You'll notice that it is no longer automatic. And if that is all that you wanted to do for this particular video, maybe you can either decide to publish the video or schedule it for any time of that you'd like to publish it. But if that's all you wanted to do, then YouTube has automatically transcribed your video into captions that you can edit from the automatic captions into manual captions so that you can index your videos and improve on the YouTube SEO of your video. So that's how you can use YouTube to automatically transcribe your videos into captions. Thanks for watching this lengthy video. I hope it has been of value. My name is David. Until next time, stay safe and never stop learning. Thank you for watching.